Traders, I'm not going to continue trading today. As you can see here, I'm going to finish in green today, over $4,000. I had three winners, three losers, but one of my winners is a huge winner in Big C. And if you're still watching Big C, it's still looking quite okay. It's still trending low. Well, I'm not sure about it anymore. But the fact is, it was an amazing winner. The rest were just kind of average, small winners, losers. What I do want to discuss today is just my last trade, which is CRM. I thought CRM should come down. CRM is kind of trending lower. It does not look like the perfect trade. If you take a look at the daily of CRM, you can probably see that it's very extended to the upside. I thought maybe it's going to come down. At that moment, I was thinking that the S&P is very likely to come down under the lows. The whole idea of taking a trade is and having some kind of an advantage is looking at the S&P 500 at all times, not only the S&P, but also at the Nasdaq. Now take a look, let's start with looking at the Nasdaq. When I took the trade, the Nasdaq was near the highs, it was not over the highs as you can see it right now, and the S&P was actually near the lows. And the S&P came down, failed to move under the lows, although the technical formation here for a breakdown is beautiful. And then it came down again. Look at this top bottoming tail here, which it left. And again, it failed to move under the lows. So for the second time, it failed. And then it came for the third time and for the fourth time. So it looked like the S&P is just about to break down under the lows. That's why I took my CRM trade short. Now, CRM may continue. I don't know. Right now, it still is holding down. But when the S&P starts making an upside move, just like it did now, probably supported by the Nasdaq here, there's no reason for me to hold on to my planned stop loss, which was over 271. So I had my planned stop loss over 271, then was thinking, because I'm not sure about the market direction, that I should have it over 270.40. And then when I finally saw this, the Nasdaq moving over the highs and the S&P moving slightly higher, then that was the time where I decided I should move out of CRM. Well, if CRM is going to come down or not, I'm not sure about that. But I did reduce my my risk by moving out at a smaller loss. And although it's getting back to green territory right now, but that's because it's doing it so far without market support. And I think I was right. At that point, when it moved over 270, it seems to me like I was right. I don't know what's coming next. Maybe it's going to continue lower, maybe it's going to continue higher. But when the S&P is moving higher, that's not the right thing to hold to a stock that is going, even if it's going the other way. So anyway, I'm out. If the S&P will in fact move under the lows, then I could possibly have had a very nice trade in CRM too. But, you know, I'm happy to be on the green side. And that's mainly because I had a red week last week, and that's quite rare. I don't usually have a red weeks. But that did happen to me last week, and I need to, you know, mentally speaking, I need to be on the green side today and trying, you know, to be careful with my trades, maybe too careful, but that's what you need to do after a red week. So that's it for me. I want to say I'm going to see you tomorrow, but that's not right. It's going to be today, later, right, Scott? We've got the Star Trader course today. Yeah, so we've got the Star Trader today. I'm going to see you there, and we're going to talk a little bit more about the S&P 500 direction and so on. And well, if it's going to come down under the lows, well, I couldn't have known that. I'll see you later today, traders. Some of you have a good day and enjoy trading. Bye, traders. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet Trading Room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its Trading Room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.